Hey, I'm Bill Jelen from MrExcel.com, and I've got a cool Excel tip for you today.
Hey, this is Mike Girvin at ExcelIsFun on YouTube, and I have a different way to do that.
Hey, welcome back. It's another Dueling Excel podcast. I'm Bill Jelen from Mr. Excel. Mike Girvin from Excel is Fun is standing right here next to me, live from Highline Community College in Seattle. Wow, today's question sent in by Ednen or LoveBite38 at YouTube. We have a lookup value here. We have to go over to the adjacent row, find the lookup value, and then grab the number that is 1 to the right and the number that is 2 to the right. Okay, so here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to start to build this using the match. Equal match, go find this value. I'm going to press F4 one, two, three times. There we go. And go look for it over here. And comma 0, right? And that's going to tell me that link is in the fourth column. If I put in 12D, then it's in the third column. All right, so that's good. That's working great. What I want to do is then take the index of that whole range over there. So way, and we want to press F4 three times to freeze the columns but not the rows, comma, and then which row? Well, that's row number 1 because there's only one row, and then the column that we want, plus 1 to get the column just to the right of it, and good, that's working. Take that whole big long thing, Control C over here, Control V, and this time we want plus 2. Oh, two equal signs at the beginning. Let's get rid of one of those. And 19. Let's do a little test. We'll change that to be WW, and we should get 12D and link. Beautiful. All right. Mike, what have you got?
Thanks, Mr. Excel. I'm going to come down here. Same little data set. I'll highlight everything. Do all the formulas at once. An active cell right there. I'll hit equal sign. And I'm going to use the same index. And I'm going to take this array right here. And we will hit F4 three times, because when we lock it over here, it needs to be locked there. But when we go down, boom, it needs to move to the next row. Comma, and then I'm going to use the same match of this. We're looking up link, 1, 2, 3 times with the F4. Get the same range right here. I'm just going to copy it, Control C and paste. Comma, 0, we're looking up an exact lookup here for match. And now, as Mr. Excel showed, when we got the link, it gave us a 4. But I really need to add 1. And when I copy it over 1 again, I need it to add 2. So I'm going to do plus columns. Columns is a great, if I can get the function right here, is a great number incrementer inside of a formula. So I'm sitting in B9, so I'm going to say $B9 colon B9, close parentheses. Right now it's saying columns B to B. How many is that? 1. This is locked, this is not. So when it goes zoop over 1, it'll say B to C, which is 2. Got to get rid of that equal sign there. Now, what in the world am I doing here? This is a column number, and I'm putting in the row number. Well, match, if there is only a columns here, it will interpret row as columns, so that'll work just fine. I'm going to Control Enter. Notice the active cell has the formula. When I Control Enter, it'll populate all the cells. Let's try a little test here. How about WW, and it looks like boom, boom, and down here it looks like it's working also, 22. All right, hand it back to Mr. Excel.
All right, there you have it. Hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next week for another Dueling Excel podcast from Mr. Excel, and Excel is fun. Excel.